Sige, start na tayo. I-discuss natin ngayon is complex trusses. But first, we have to be able to differentiate ano yung simple truss, compound truss, saka complex truss. So, for a simple truss, it is possible to create a simple truss by joining three bars together to form a triangle. And then we can increase the size of the truss by adding two more members with an additional joint. So, essentially, pag meron daw tayong three bars, let's say, eto, this is the first bar, then we have another one, then another bar, meron tayong tatlong bars forming a triangle, this is a simple truss. Now, if I will add two joints daw, I mean two bars, yan, meron siyang isang joint, yan, with an additional joint. Adding two more members with an additional joint. So, this is still a simple truss. Yan. And then, I can add another, I can add two more members. Let's say, ito. And then, yan. So, ito yung bagong joint. So, this is still a simple truss. Now, a compound truss naman is made up of simple trusses joined together to form a larger truss using a bar and a common joint. So, sabihin natin, we have this simple truss. Yan. Diba, this is a simple truss. And then, what if dalawang simple trusses, so, copy ko yan. Pwede ko yan silang i-connect. Yan. And then, I will add another bar dito sa taas. Yan. So, this is essentially a compound truss. Dalawang simple trusses na kinonect natin using another bar. And then, meron siyang common joint. Yan. Now, yung complex trusses naman is a type of truss that cannot be identified as simple or compound. So, yung arrangement niya forms a complicated framework, and then using the method of joints and sections do not immediately help in analyzing the structure. So usually it incorporates overlapping members. So an example of this is itong member na to. So meron tayong overlapping members AD saka BC. Yan. So sa truss na to, you can check any joint. Any joints, for example, joint A, merong tatlong members. Sa joint C, meron ding tatlong members, and so on. Yung joint E din, saka joint F. So, hindi siya masosolve directly using equilibrium equations. So, yung gagawin natin is, we have to apply more advanced methods talaga. Now, isa dyan sa advanced methods is itong substitute member method. You can still apply the method of joints sa truss natin, but again, you will require more equations. And then, mas tedious yung solution natin. So, for the complex truss shown daw, determine the forces in member AF, BC, and DE using the substitute member method. And then, the force P is to be taken as 30 kN. So, 30 pala yan. Now, na-model na natin to kanina, so i-check na lang natin kung ano yung forces niya. So, for the substitute member method, the first step is to remove any member. Yan. So, you can remove, let's say, member AF, member AD, or any member dyan. Then, the second step is to replace the removed member by another member that will make the complex truss easy to solve. Now, the added member must connect yung mga joints na nasa original truss natin. So, for example, tatanggalin ko si EF and then pwede kong i-add si member AB. Kasi yung member AB, eto, yung bagong member natin, connects two joints, A and B. Yan. So, dapat nasa joint ka lang ng original truss. And then, sa first phase natin, we have to solve the force of the new member that we added sa step 2. And then, meron tayong second phase we will remove all the applied loads and then solve natin yung force in the removed member in step 1. Ipapakita ko na lang yung buong process kasi mas maganda pag meron na tayong example. And then yung tip ko sa step 4, sa second phase, just apply a unit load. And then yung unit load mo, just pair a variable S once you will be able to solve it. And then for step 5, adding the forces in steps 3 and 4 must amount to 0. Kasi yung substitute member was initially, diba, non-existent siya. Inadd lang natin siya to apply the substitute member method. And then once the force in the removed member is solved, you may also obtain the forces in other members. Ayan. So, we have this truss. And then, una natin isosolve yung reactions lang muna. So, ito yan. Yan, isosolve natin yung reactions. Now first, we have to resolve the forces P into components para mas madali siyang i-analyze. So, ano yung angle na yan? Diba, we know this is 60 degrees. So, if I will draw a straight line here, ayan, then this must be 30 degrees, diba? So, if this is 30 degrees, perpendicular man yan, eto. Yan. But, I can draw a straight vertical line para mas ma-analyze natin siya further. So, if this is 30 degrees, diba, perpendicular to. So, if this is 30, this must be 60 degrees. Yan. And then, if this is 60, ano yung natira? This will be 30 degrees. Kasi, perpendicular yung angle na yan. And so, if I am to draw a straight horizontal line right here, then this must be 60 degrees. Kasi 30 yan, and then perpendicular kasi to. So, 60 degrees yan with respect to the horizontal. Now, mas gusto ko yung with respect to the horizontal para yung x component, gagamitan ko ng cosine, and then yung vertical component, gagamitan ko naman ng sine. So, the same din yan dito. This is also inclined 60 degrees from the horizontal. So, sulat na lang natin. Yan, 60 degrees. So, meron siyang components. Ito, sabihin natin, Px. Ito naman, Py. Ayan. So, yung value ng Px is P cosine 60. Value naman ng Py is P sine 60. And then, ito rin. P sine 60 saka P cos 60. Ayan. So, masosolve na natin yung reaction sa either A or B. So, dito na lang ako sa A mag-moment. Para yung vertical component ng Py tatama sa point A. Mas madali siyang isolve. So, summation of moments about point A. Diba, meron tayong reaction dito. This is Ay. Then, meron din tayong reaction sa hinge. Now, yung dalawang forces, yung components niya are acting to the right. So, the force here must be acting to the left. So, sabihin natin Ax. And then, ito naman, this is By. Yan. So, summing up moments about A, we have Px or P cos 60. Now, P is 30 kN, so 30 cosine 60. Multiply natin by its moment arm. Moment arm nito is this distance, so 2 meters. Multiplied by 2. And then we have this one, P cos 60, so plus 30 cos 60. Clockwise yung rotations nila. Again, my convention is positive yung clockwise moments. So the moment arm of this load naman, yung P cos 60, is this distance plus 2 meters. So, ano yung distance na yan? Ito. Distance EF. To solve that, we can consider this triangle. Yung triangle na yan. So, we have this reference angle. So, this is the side opposite to the reference angle. Ito naman yung adjacent to the reference angle. So, pwede ko palang gamitin yung tangent function. So, tangent of 60 degrees equals opposite over adjacent. So, opposite is itong distance na to. So, 4 meters divided by this distance. So, EF is unknown. So, EF pala is 4 divided by tangent 60. Yan. So, 4 square root of 3 divided by 3. So, in decimal, ito yan, 2.309. So, shift store, lalagay ko na lang sa C. Kasi indicated dyan na C meters. So, multiply ko to by C. Ayan. Now, notice na the same lang yung forces. 30 cos 60, saka ito rin. So, we can just factor out 30 cos 60. And then, i-join ko na lang dito sa parenthesis yung C. So, instead of 2, and then sinaparate natin, gagawin na lang natin 2 plus C. Ayan. And then, for PY naman, the vertical component of this load tatama sa point A. So, wala yung rotation na makukos. Ito lang. So, meron tayong P sine 60 na vertical component. It will cause a clockwise rotation about point A. So, gagawin natin plus 30 sine 60 vertical component, multiply natin by this perpendicular distance, 4 meters. So, times 4 equals 0. Meron pa palang BY. Sorry. So, itong BY, it will cause a counterclockwise rotation pag ito yung hawakan natin. So, minus BY, tas multiplied by 8 meters. So, yan, 8 equals 0. So, 30 cos 60 multiplied by 2 plus C. Ayan. Then, plus 30 sine 60 times 4 minus BY times 8 equals 0. So, ito pala yung reaction at B. Check down natin na. Minus X. Check natin dito. Ito. 24 dapat. 24. Wait lang ha. Check ko lang. Ito, 30 cos 60 times 2 plus... Sorry. Yung moment arm ng P cos 60 is C plus 2. Yan, sorry na overlook ka. So, ito na lang. 2 plus moment arm of the other load is 2 plus C. Ayan. Again, C plus 2 for this component. Lagyan lang natin ng plus 2. So, the force in BY is 24.82. So, since reaction yan sa B, isusort ko yan sa letter B. Ayan. So, BY equals 24.82 kilonewtons. And then, solving the reaction at A, we can sum up forces vertical. So, we have AY acting upward, then minus P sine 60, dalawang P sine 60. So, minus 2 times 30 sine 60 plus BY. It must be equal to 0. So, AY pala is, recall B, negative, then plus 2 times 30 sine 60. So 27.14. Itong value na to. Again, hindi yan exact kasi sa distance natin dito nag-approximate lang tayo. So 27.14 lang din siya virtually. Ayan. So shift store lalagay ko sa A. 27.14 kN. And then to solve AX naman, we can just sum up forces horizontal. So we have dalawang P cos 60. So opposing direction sila, so i-equate na lang natin agad. So 2 times 30 cosine 60. So ano yan? We have positive 30. Yan. So tama yung assumption natin na to the left siya. This is AX. So isusulat na lang natin yung reactions. 27.14 yan. And then ito naman 24.82. While this is 30. Yan. So yung hanap and down natin is are the following. The forces in member AF, this one, BC, eto, and also DE, which is this one. Now, para mas challenging, I will just remove a member na hindi kasali sa forces natin. Para mas ma-internalize niya talaga. So, ikakopy ko na lang to. Ayan. So, copy natin. And then, ito yung member na I will remove. Member AD. So, remove member AD. Yan. And then, let's try to replace this member by member CF. Ito. Replace by member CF. Ayan. So, yung gagawin natin is tatanggalin natin to. Yan. Again, walang magbabago sa reactions regardless sa internal forces natin or internal members. So, remove natin to, AD. Papalitan natin ng member CF. Mag-add tayo. So, ibahin natin yung color. Wait lang. Orange na lang. So, this is our member CF. Ayan. Now, this is, again, the first step and second step. Remove any member. Yung tinanggal natin is member AD. Ayan. So, natanggal na natin siya. And then, replace the removed member by another member. So, again, dapat yung bagong member must connect two joints. So, itong member CF yan. Now sa first phase, solve the force of the new member in step 2. Now, ito yung new member natin. So, isosolve natin yan. So, let's first analyze kung ano yung zero force members sa system na to. So, diba, pag merong meron kang joint, tas merong dalawang members, and then the joint is unloaded, yung dalawang members mo would be zero force members. Now, looking at joint D, walang external reactions dito. I mean, walang external loads. And then, we have two members. So, itong dalawang members will be zero force members. Ayan. Now, if zero force members yan, madali na lang i-analyze yung mga forces natin dito. Yan. So, we can just use two equations, two unknowns. Now, para mas madali, sa MathCAD ko na lang ilalagay yung solutions natin. So, screenshot ko na lang. And then, for any supporting figure, idodraw na lang natin and then i-add ko na lang doon. And then, yung PDF natin will be posted sa subscriber hub. Ayan. So, eto. And then, sulat na lang din natin yung solution natin sa AY saka BY. So, copy ko to. Yan. So, summation of moments about A equals 0. And then, P equals 30. So, P cosine 60 times pi over 180 multiply natin by 2 plus C. And then, yung C naman natin is tangent of 60 degrees equals opposite 4 divided by C. So, solve C. Ayan. Then, plus 30 sine 60. By the way, meron yung pi over 180 kasi rad yung default na MathCAD. Huwag niyong lagyan sa calculators niyo. Then, times 4 minus by times 8 equals 0. So, solve by. Ayan. So, para ma-store natin yung value na to, declare natin yan dito. So, by, then press colon. Ayan. So, naka-store na si by. And then, summing of forces naman, along y, we have AY tas minus 2 times 30 sine 60 times pi over 180 plus BY equals 0. So, solve AY. Ayan. So, still, declare natin. And then, summation of forces along x, we have AX equal to 2 times P cos 60 times pi over 180. Ayan. So, papalitan ko lang din yung 30 dito. So, P saka ito. Ayan. So, meron na tayong reactions. And then, isosolve na natin by joint. So, dito muna tayo sa, anong joint ba to? Joint E. Ito. Kasi, ito, zero force member. So, pag andyan ka sa joint E, meron kang dalawang members na lang. Bala, ito yung mahihara. Draw natin na. So, at joint E, this is a zero force member, so we can just remove that. So, ito na lang yung forces natin sa joint E. What if copy ko na lang to? Then we have this one. Yan. So, meron tayong CE saka EF. Now, again, yung style ko sa trusses is I will just assume na tension lahat ng members. So, kaya away from the joint yan lahat. Now, hindi ko na sinali yung force dito kasi again, we identified it as a zero force member. So, ito na lang yung gagamitin natin. So, screenshot ko yung joint E. And then, dito natin ilalagay yung equations. Yan. So, at joint E, we can sum up forces vertical. Yan, equal to 0. So, we have CE times, cosine 60. yung vertical component niya times pi over 180, and then minus EF equals 0, and then summation of forces naman along X, we have CE then sine 60 negative. Then times pi over 180. Tapos meron tayong p cos 60. Ito. I mean, meron pa pala tayong minus p then sine 60. Yan, for the external load. Then plus p cosine 60 times pi over 180. So press equals then 0. So ito yung dalawang equations natin. And then since meron tayong dalawang unknown, CE saka EF, then let me just express this as EF na lang. Yan, so ito yung value ng EF. So copy ko to. Combine ng equations 1 and 2. Ito, this is EF. So, wait lang. Solvable pala yung CE. Masasolve na natin siya agad. So, ano na lang. Dalawang members na lang pala. So, CE. Ito yung value niya, 17.321. So, store ko siya sa variable CE. And then, ito naman, lalagay ko na lang sa bottom para naka-store na si CE. Ayan. Summation of forces FY. So, solving EF, EF naman is this one. So, minus 17.32. Wait lang. CE, negative pala to. Kasi yung vertical component ng CE is going downward. Yan. So, negative 34.64. Naka-KN yan lahat. So, tapos na tayo sa joint E. So, we can now proceed to any joint dyan. Now, pag andyan ka sa joint C, meron kang isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat. Apat na members. So, it isn't ideal to start here. Sorry, excuse me. It's not ideal to proceed dito sa joint C. So, pwede tayo sa joint B kasi this is a zero force member, and then we have isa tas dalawa. Dalawang members. So, pwede natin yan siyang i-draw. So, at joint B, yan, this is joint B. We have the force BY. Then, ito, member BF. So, yung triangles niya, for along X, diba, this is a triangle man. Ito. So, along X, for yung distance, and then along Y, 2. So, yung ratio ng triangle natin is 4, 2. Then we're gonna solve the hypotenuse para makuha natin yung components niya. And then we have another member, this one. This is member BC. Again ha, this member saka ito. Then sa sides natin, ito yung triangle na i-consider natin. Yung buo talaga. So, sa triangle na yan, along X, it has a distance of 4 plus 4. So, 8. So, 8 yan. And then, it has a height of 2 meters. So, 2. Ayan. So, copy ko to. And then dito tayo gagawa ng equations. Yan. So the length of member BF, ano na lang, L BF. This is square root of 2 squared plus 4 squared. Yan. And then the length of member BC naman is square root of 2 squared, this one, 2 plus 8 squared. So, ano yan? Diba, 8.246. So, we can now form equations summing up forces along x saka y. Ayan. So, summing up forces along x, lahat ng forces natin, although alam natin na merong isa dyan na compression, i-assume na lang natin na lahat is tension. So, lahat ng components along x are going to the left. So, minus lahat. Minus BC times the component along x is 8. Diba? So, 8 divided by the length of BC. Yan yung ratio ng sides natin. And then, minus BF times eto, 4. Then, divided by the length of member BF. Tas, na ito lang, then equals 0. So, since meron tayong dalawang unknowns, let's just express one variable in terms of the other. So, sabi natin, BC. And ito yung force ng BC. Ayan. And then, for FY naman, summation of forces along Y, we have the force in BY going upward. Lahat ng components din ng BF saka BC along Y is acting upward. So, plus BC times 2, kasi yan yung vertical component, so 2 divided by the length of BC. Then, plus BF naman times 2 pa rin, divided by length of BF, set to 0. And then, solve natin si BF. Ayan. So, BF pala is negative 111 point something. Ayan. And then, solving BC, ito lang. We will just copy this. Or, pwede natin siyang i-copy na lang dito. Ito na lang. Wait lang. This is BC. So, store natin sa BF. Wait lang. Try ko. Bad solve variable. Clear ko na lang. Clear BC. Ayan. So, BC is 102.33757. Yan. So, highlight ko na lang lahat. Ito yung CE, EF, and then ito naman yung CE. Yan. So, lalagay ko yan sa EF. Yan. So, meron na tayong forces in BF saka BC. And then, balik tayo sa figure. Meron na tayong force dito. But if andyan tayo sa joint C, alam na natin to. I mean, di pa natin to alam. Saka, ito rin. Di pa natin alam. So, we can proceed to joint A. But again, depende lang yan sa diskarte mo. So, sa joint A na lang ako. So, copy ko na lang to. Ayan. Copy ko yan and then yan, erase natin. Then, we have member AF saka AC connected at joint A. AC. Ayan. And then, for AF, the triangle is 4 along X, and then along Y, we have a distance of 2. The same ratio dito. So, four saka 2. Yan. So, screenshot ko na lang to. This is joint A. So, here we have AC. Ano pala? Summation of forces along Y. We have AC going upward and then plus AF multiplied by 2 then divided by the length. Diba yung length ng AF the same sa length ni BF. So, ano na lang para clear talaga. Gagawin ko na lang yung AF. Yan. So, divided by the length of AF. Then, we have AY. So, plus AY, this must be equal to 0. So, solve AC muna. Yan. And then, summation din tayo ng forces along X. So, here we have AF multiplied by 4 divided by the length of AF. And then, going to the right yan, then AX is going to the left, which is 30. So, set to 0. Then, solve AF. So, AF pala is 33.54. Yan, yung force dyan. And so, move ko na lang to sa ilalim. Wait lang. So, store ko yan sa AF. Then, we have AC. Ito. AC is negative 42.141. Ayan. Then, finally, we have dito na tayo sa joint C naman. Bala, ito. So, alam na natin yung force dito, saka dito. So, so for joint C, merong dalawang members na natira. CF, saka CE. So, idodraw natin yan. This is, again, joint A. So, sa joint C, ito yan. Copy ko na lang to. So, ayan. And then, don't forget, meron pa tayong BC. Member BC. So, ito. Yan. So, AC BC then CF saka CE. Ayan. But again, no na to. No na yung BC, no na din, no na rin yung AC. Ayan. Saka yung CE din. Ito, from joint E. So, madali na lang yung joint C. So, solve na lang natin si CF. Ayan. But pwede rin na dito tayo sa joint F. Depende na yan sa discard mo. But since nasimulan ko na to, ito na lang. So, yan. So yung kulang na lang natin is member CF. So to solve CF, since this is a force going to the right, horizontal, there's a sum of forces along X. Ayan. So here we have P cos 60 going to the right. Then we have CE still going to the right, so plus CE times, ito yung angle niya with respect to the horizontal, so CE cosine 30. And then plus CF, then plus BC. Ano nga yung ratio ng BC? Check ko dito ah. Ito yung BC. So, along X, it has a distance of 8. So, multiplied by 8 divided by the length of BC. Ito, yung nasolve natin kanina. So, solve CE. CF pala. Sorry. So CF is negative 129.282. So hulayan natin ng yellow. So meron na tayong forces sa lahat ng members para sa bagong system natin, na pinalitan natin yung member AD by member CF. Ayan. Now since tapos na tayo, itong ginawa natin, ito yung phase 1. Wait lang. Phase 1. Ayan. And then for phase 2 naman, lagyan natin phase 2. Ayan. Babasahin ko ulit ah. In the second phase, remove all the applied loads. So ito, yung applied loads natin na 30 kN, i-omit natin. And then solve the forces in the removed member, solve the force in the removed member in terms of the variable S. Then again, yung tip ko dito, ito yung nasa books, but yung ginagawa ko sa nung undergrad is I will apply a unit load. So ito yung gagawin natin. Copy ko to. This one na lang. Ayan. So for the second phase, tatanggalin daw natin lahat ng loads. Lahat ng external loads. So wala na yan siya. Pero wala. Yan. Wala na yan, saka ito. Yan. So, diba, meron tayong dinagdag na member sa CF. So, again, C yan. And then, this was our new member. Yan. Yung naka-orange. And then, diba, tinanggal natin si AD. Now, ngayon, yung AD, it will be expressed ibang color na lang. Ano ba? Green na lang. Wait lang. Yung purple na lang. Yan. So, ito, express natin in terms of a variable. Yung nakalabel doon sa taas is S. So, assume din natin na tension siya. Yan, S. And then, tatanggalin natin siya. Ayan. So, ito na yung second system na i-analyze natin. But since wala tayong external loads, di ba, tinanggal natin yung external loads applied at joint C saka E. Meaning, wala na din tayong external reactions. So, wala na yung reaction, wala nang reaction yung hinge sa car ruler. So, tatanggalin natin yan. And then, ito rin. Wala na to. Ayan. And then, wala na rin AX. Yan. For a while, ah. Yan. So, diba, medyo mahirap if we are to solve this in terms of variables talaga. So, yung ginagawa ko is, I will just treat this as 1. Ito yung ibig kong sabihin sa unit load. Balik tayo, ah. Yan. Apply a unit load in replacement of the removed member. So, instead of using S or a variable, then I will just use 1. And then yung coefficient or yung forces in the members, ano na lang, ipipair ko na lang with S para masolve ko yung S mamaya. Anyway, papakita ko lang kung paano siya gamitin. So, yan. Lalagyan natin ng 1. And then, solve natin lahat ng forces sa members, DE, CE, and the rest. Yan. So, paano ba to? Diba, this is 1. Again, walang reactions yung lahat ng support. So, 0 yan. 0, saka ito. Ayan. So, I can start sa saan ba? Ito, unloaded, merong force dyan. Dito na lang tayo sa A magsa-start. Kasi, if dito tayo sa A, meron tayong dalawang members, AC saka AF. And then ito, this is treated as an applied load. Yan, again, i-treat natin yan as 1. So, sa joint A, we have this triangle is ano pala? Corresponding to member AD, so 8 meters along X and then 2 meters along Y. Ayan. So at joint A, copy ko na lang to. Then this is 4 saka 2. Member AF. And we have member AC. Ayan. So, copy natin to and then sa MathCAD tayo mag gagawa ng solution. So, ayan. So, sa joint A, copy ko na lang yung solution kanina. So, ito yung joint A natin. But we have to add member AD. So, ito yung mayayara. Lagyan natin ng length of member AD, which is square root of 2 squared plus 8 squared. Ayan. And then again, tinreat natin siya as 1 para mas madali. So AF, ano na lang, since this is sa phase 2, sabihin natin, this is a virtual system. Yan. So, lalagyan ko ng V. Subscript na V. Lahat ng forces dito. So, AF, V na lang yan. Saka ito. Then, AC, subscript V. Yan. And then, yung nagbago dito is, wala na tayong 13 na applied load. Galing kasi yan sa reaction kanina. Now, we have a load of 1, then it's horizontal component. So, minus, I mean, plus pala, kasi to the right siya. So, plus 1 times 8, yung horizontal component niya, divided by the length of AD. Kasi diba, S corresponds to member AD. So, ito yung force ng member AF sa second phase natin. And then, to solve, ano naman, member AC, yan, we have to sum up forces vertical. So, ACV, ayan, then, plus AFV, component niya, then we have to add the vertical component of this force, yung S. So again, tinit natin yan as 1. So 1 multiplied by the vertical component, which is 2, divided by the length of AD. Yan. So we have 0.2425. Yan. Ito yung force ng member AC sa virtual system natin. Again, hindi virtual system yung tawag dito, but gusto ko siyang tawagin as virtual system kasi nag-apply ako ng unit load. Yan. San ba next? Sa ano na lang? Sa joint D na lang tayo. Kasi sa joint D, we have member DE saka member BD. So, dalawang unknowns lang. So, copy ko na lang yan. Yan. Then, we have here member DE. This is 30 degrees. Then also member BD. So joint D. Ayan. And then sulat ko na lang din yung ratios natin. So 2 saka 8. Ayan. So, sa joint D, meron tayong solutions kanina. Saan na yun, ha? Joint D. CB. Wala pala. Ano na lang? Solve na lang natin ulit. So, we can sum up forces. Yan. Forces along Y equal to 0. So, meron tayong ano na lang, mas madali pala pag X. Yan. So, yung component ng DE along X is going to the left. So, DE then cosine 30. And then, minus S, or again, treated as 1 yan. So, 1 times the horizontal component, 8, divided by the length of AD. Then, equal yan to 0. So solve DE. Yan, store ko yan sa DE din. And then lalagyan ko ng V. So DEV. Wait lang. Na-solve ba natin kanina? Meron tayong BD. Ah, kanina pala, yung BD saka DE are zero force members. Kaya hindi natin siya nasala. Yan. Proceed na lang tayo. So, ito, DEV. So, negative 1.12. Then, summing up forces along Y equal to 0. We have DE going up. So, DEV, then sine 30 times pi over 180. Ayan. Then, minus 1 times the vertical component, 2, divided by the length of AD. Then, we have minus BD. Ayan. So, equal to 0. So, solve BD. So, negative 0.8026. Ayan. So, store ko yan sa BD subscript V. Yan. So, tapos na tayo sa joint A saka joint D. So, dito naman tayo sa joint E naman. So, sa joint E, ito yung figure. Ito na lang gagamitin ko. So, merong dalawang members dyan. CE saka DE. Ito yung member EF. And then this is CE and this is DE. So joint E. Ayan. So here, we can sum up forces along X. Copy na lang natin yung solutions, solutions kanina sa joint E. Ito. But again, meron lang tayong ititweak sa solution natin. Ayan. So, gagawin ko tong V, subscript V, saka ito rin. EF V. Ayan. Then for the applied loads, walang applied loads dyan. So summation of forces along X, we have this one, CE going to the left, and then plus DE going to the right. So it still has the same component. Bala DE times, ito yung angle with respect sa vertical, so sine multiplied by sine 60. Yan. So, CEV pala is just equal to DE sub V. So, kung ano yung value ng andito, yan. Wait lang. L DE yan dapat. Yan, kung ano yung value ng DE dyan, eto, -1.12, yan din yung value dito. Then, summation of forces along Y, we have CE and DE going downward. Bala, lahat ng yan. So, meron akong ima-minus na DE sub V multiplied by cosine 60 times pi over 180. Ayan. Then, minus EFV. Tapos, wala na to. Kasi kanina yan sa phase 1. So, the force in CE is -1.12 and then the force in EF is wait lang, ba't naging positive yan? If this is compression, dapat compression din to. Wait lang. CEV. Then, okay. Yung component ng DE is going to the right. So, it must be plus. Sorry. Ano pala to? Summation of forces along Y. So, lahat ng yan going downward. Dapat. Wait lang. Ba't naging positive? Downward. Ito rin. Downward. Saan ba yung DEV? Ito. -0.8 to the left, to the right. Wait lang. Ba't iba? Okay. EFV pala to. Yan. So, positive 1.12. Sorry. Tama lang yan. Then, meron na tayong CE saka EF. So, tapos na tayo sa joint A, joint D, saka sa joint E. So, we can now proceed to itong roller muna. Kasi alam na natin yung force in BD, yung kanina. So, masasolve natin yung force ng BC saka BF. Ayan. So, saan ba yung joint B? Ito. So, copy ko na lang yan. Wait lang. Merong picture yata dito. Ito. And then, copy natin yung solution sa joint B. Masyadong mahaba talaga yung ano natin. Process. Ito. Yan. So, summing of forces sa joint B, gawin natin tong BCV. Yan. And then we have BY. Sa case na to, BY is equal to 0. Kasi wala nang force dyan. So, tatanggalin na lang natin. Yan. Lagay ko na lang. BY is equal to 0. For the second phase. Wait lang. Ayan. So, BF, vertical component, going upward, saka yung BC. So, it must be equal to 0. So, ito, gagawin natin BCV, saka ito rin. So, solve BFV. Ayan, negative 55.5. Then, yung isa is 51.68. Wait lang. Ano yung BC dito? BCV. Negative BCV times 8 over LBC minus BF. BFV yan. BFV. So, ba't naging 0? Wait lang. Ah, okay. BFV yan dapat. BFV. Then, 2 divided by LBC. Saka ito rin. Saan yung BF? BF is this one. Ah, okay. Sorry. May kulang yung figure natin. Copy ko lang to, ah. Yan. Hindi na kasi zero force member yung BD. So, lalagay natin yan. BD. So, it will affect our solution sa along Y. Summation of forces along Y. So, ito na lang. Then, we have to add plus BD underscore V. Ito. Enter. So, 3.58 pala. Yan. And then, ito, dapat BCV din yan. And ito, BFV. Then, solve BC sub V. Bad solve variable. Clear BCV. Ayan. So, negative 3.309 yung member BF. Tama ba? Ito. So, minus 8. Then, another minus para sa BFV. 3.58. Then, ito, 3.31. Yan. Tama lang. And then, ano ba yung kulang natin? Tapos na sa A, A, D, E, saka B. Ito, E, E, B. So, pwede na tayo sa joint F or sa joint C. Sa joint C na lang tayo kasi yan naman din, yan na lang din yung kulang natin. So, copy ko na lang to. Ayan. Then we have member BC for a while. Eto. So BC CF CE then AC. Ayan. Joint C. Then again, this is 30 degrees. Ito naman. Component is 2 saka 8. So, screenshot ko to. And then, proceed tayo. Ayan. So, for joint C naman, copy na lang din natin yung solutions natin kanina. So, this one. And then iiba na lang natin. Wala na to. And then CEV, this is now CE sub V. Yan, to the right, so positive pa rin. CF is going to the right, purely horizontal. Then BC is still going to the right, but this is now BCV. Ito rin gawin natin CFV. So wala pa palang value yung BCV natin. Hindi ko kasi na-declare dito. Yan. So dapat 4.1807. Ito yung value ng CF. So I think ito na lang yung kulang. Kasi meron na tayong ACV. Ito, alam na natin, alam na din natin yung BC. So ito na lahat ng forces natin. So gagawin natin, balik tayo sa steps. Ayan. Adding the forces in steps 3 and 4 must amount to 0 since the substitute member was initially non-existent. So sa first phase natin, ito, this was phase 1. Ano yung force in the added member? Diba yung in-add natin na member was member CF. Ito. So ano yung force dyan sa first phase? In the first phase, we got a value of negative 129.28. So copy ko yan. Yan. So lalagyan ko equate forces in for the added member. Must be equal to 0. Yan. So ito yung nakuha natin sa phase 1. And then sa phase 2 naman, phase 2, yung nakuha natin na force is ito. Ito yung force in member CF. But again, this was considering a unit load. So, yung unit load must be paired with a variable S. Again, yung ginawa ko is, I just treated this one, eto, yung force in member AD, instead of using a variable S, ginawa ko na lang 1. So, meron pala yung kadugtong na S, yung value na to. So, copy natin, then, plus this value, tas dudugtangan natin ng S. So, the force S, yan yung force sa missing member. Or essentially, yung tinanggal natin kanina. Kasi, balik tayo ah. Yung ginawa nating S is member AD. Diba? So, kung ano yung S na masosolve ko dyan, yan pala yung force ng member AD sa actual thrust na natin. So, set natin to 0, then solve S. Yan. So, the force in member AD pala is 30.923. So, lagay ko na lang AD. So, again, galing to sa phase 1. Ito naman galing sa phase 2. But again, sa phase 2, huwag mong kalimutan na dugtungan ng S yung solution. So, pag i-check natin yan sa binuo natin kanina na truss dito, yan. So the force in member AD, this one yung naka blue, is 30.92. so diba, the same lang dito, 30.92. meron lang discrepancy sa decimal kasi again yung force, yung length natin for this member was approximated lang, di natin ginawang exact kasi nag node lang kasi tayo. Yan. So 30.923. So sir, paano kukunin yung forces in the other members? Now, para holistic yung discussion natin, although yung hinahanap lang sa problem is yung hinahanap lang sa problem are forces in member AF, BC, and DE. But hanapin ko na lang lahat kasi naka-mathcad naman yung solution natin. So, bale, ito yung gagawin ko. Ito, naka-store to sa CE sub V. Ayan. And then, ito naman, naka-store sa wait lang. Hindi ko pala siya na-store. Store ko sa CF. CF pala to. CFV. Ba't nawala? Ah, okay, ito. Hindi ko na-store. Yan. So, ito yung force in member AD. So, kung gusto ko yung force in the other members, then I will just actually add, since alam ko na yung value ng S, ayan, lalagay ko na lang siya sa S lahat. Ayan. And then, gagawin ko, for member, ano ba yan? Ito na lang, dito na lang ako mag-check. So, we have member AC. So, to solve the force in member AC, we have AC for phase 1, then plus AC sa phase 2, multiplied by S. The same lang yung formula. Ito lang din. Yan. Equal dapat to 0. So, solve. Ano naman? Hindi na isosolve natin. Equal na lang. Kasi meron na tayong S. Nasolve na natin. 30.92. So, ito yung actual force in member AC. Yan. 34.641. Tama ba? Check natin na. San ba yung member AC? Eto, diba? So, the force in member AC is 34.64. So, diba? Tama lang. 34.641. And then, doon naman tayo sa member, ano to? Member, ito na lang. AF. Sa member AF naman tayo. For member AF, we have AF plus AF sub V multiplied by S. So, equals 0. So, yan yung sinabi ko kanina na these members pala, itong AF, I mean, ano nga yan? Yes, AF saka BF are actually zero force members. Now, hindi yan nag-zero exactly kasi again, nag-approximate tayo dito. But, dito, exact values kasi yung ginamit natin sa buong solutions. So, kaya naging zero talaga siya. Yan. Yan din yung reason bakit nag-mathcad ako ngayon. Yan. So, ano naman, for member AC tapos na AF, AD tapos na din. For member BC naman tayo. So, for member BC, we have BC plus BC sa virtual system multiplied by S equals 0 pa rin yan. Kasi diba, times 10 to the negative 14. That's virtually 0. Yan. Then, sa ano naman? Member CE. So, this is CE plus CE sub V multiplied by S equals negative 17.32. So, ito. Diba? Negative 17.32 kasi compression. Kaya negative siya. Ayan. And then, this member naman, saan na yan? Ito, member EF. So, for member EF, we have EF plus EF sub V multiplied by S equals 0. So, this is also a zero force member. Yan. And then member, ano naman, member, ano nga yan? DE. Now, di natin nasulat kanina, kasi member DE and, wait lang. Member DE and BD became zero force members kasi. So, we have to add that dito. Ito na lang. So, BD equals 0 saka DE. Yan. Ba't naging undefined? Wait lang. Ah, dito na lang. So, BD equals 0 saka DE. Yan. So, for member BD, we have BD plus BD underscore V multiplied by S equals negative 24.821. Ito. Yan. 24.82 then compression. Kaya negative. Then next, BD, doon naman tayo sa DE. So, DE is DE plus DE sub V multiplied by S. Ayan. Negative 34.64. Ito. Compression. Excuse me. Tapos na ba? Wait na. AC. AC, AF, BC, CE, EF, BD, DE. Wala pang BF, but alam natin na BF is also a zero force member. So, BF plus BF underscore V times S equals zero din. Yan. So, ito lang yung basic steps talaga sa ano tawag dito? Substitute member method. So, madali lang siya, but you have to solve talaga the forces in all members using the method of joints. So, yung key concepts lang dito is review mo lang talaga yung zero force members. Kasi pag nag-substitute ka, it will be helpful sa solution mo. So, ito lang. Now, natagalan lang tayo kasi sinolve ko kasi lahat. Pero pag isang, wait lang. Dito sa problem natin, yung hinahanap lang, AF, BC, saka DE. Once ma-solve mo na yung ED using the substitute member method, pwede mo nang isolve yung buong system talaga. Papalitan mo lang yung force ng member na to. Yan. So, once ma-solve mo na yung AD pala, you can go back to the original system and then solve as it is. So, you can apply the method of sections depende sa kung ano yung ideal. Yan. So, yung PDF copy ng MathCAD solution natin, ipopost ko sa Subscriber Hub. Ayan. So, ito na lang muna. Substitute member method. Ayan. So, again ha. So that you can practice, you can try removing another member. Huwag mong gamitin yung AD. Let's say, remove mo yung member AF, then papalitan mo ng member AB. Pwede rin yan. Ito, bala, ito na yung force mo, and then ito yung tatanggalin mo. Yan, pwede din yan.